told I said the funniest thing when I surprised him in the shower the other day. What was
it? And that is the new voice for Wascot. Welcome to the newest patch for Monday Night Combat. It was released a little early this week. The notes went up on Wednesday night, and the patch itself came out actually like 2 hours ago as I'm recording this, so I said to get a video up on Thursday, and I meant it. Luckily, the patch came out early, so I can get both the video out today and cover the patch as well. However, this is a much smaller patch, so there's not a whole lot to talk about. They are really ramping up for PAX at this point. They have one patch left before PAX. It's going to be a... This is going to be a same size as most patches, maybe a little larger. It's going to be out right before PAX. I'm guessing it's the week of PAX, probably April 4th or 5th maybe, so they can be on hand to push a patch for if any mistakes are made. So they're not preoccupied with PAX at the same time as they have issues with the patch as well. But we'll see how that works out. But it's not going to be the same Thursday that it usually is. They're going to skip next Thursday's patch. But this patch itself, it doesn't introduce a whole lot of new changes. They nerfed Meta Ball Lightning. It is back to its original price. The duration was reduced a little bit. It's still higher than normal, 15 seconds instead of 10. But the price is now back to 250, and most people are saying that the duration was the real sticking point, not the price. And the price should probably, and I agree with this, I think the price should go back down to about 150, 100, and the duration remain at 10. Because the problem really wasn't ever the effect itself, it was just the... You're paying the same price as a Regenidol for a few seconds of speed. Nice, but not that useful. Besides that, we have another balance change for Carl. His damage on his handler got got reduced to 125 from 150. There's been a lot of talk about balancing Carl, but I don't play a whole lot of Carl. I'm not sure where to start. Some say it's Junior, some say it's Alt Fire, some say it's a stun. I don't really know. I can say that I have died to balancing buddies quite a bit lately, but that's more carelessness than anything to do with Carl. Anyway, other changes include some visual perks to bots. As you see, the jungle bots now have a green coloring, as well as the lane bots. Basically, this is a show. Most bots and turrets in the game have a little bit of coloring. They get closer to red as they get lower in life. And this patch basically made that a bit more prominent. It was always there, but wasn't as prominent as before, so that's a nice change. You have an idea how healthy something is before you can kill it. I think it's a little more prominent on turrets as well. Turrets are the one thing I had a problem, because they would spark really early. But it's looking a little bit better now, from my opinion. You see right there, the turrets. You see the green a bit more prominent there. As for other changes, I know the biggest change was the voice acting. They added a voice for Megabeth and Wascot. I wasn't even aware Wascot really was going to get a new voice. I figured he was going to pretty much keep using the same voice he used as Bullseye. A few altercations here and there. Nothing super major. But they actually give him a full revamp voice. He has got a very creepy, depressed sounding voice. Like, I guess a stalker he's sort of made out to be in his profile. But looking at other changes here, not a whole lot of other changes. They have a range nerf for Gunslinger's kneecap. It's not a complete nerf, it's just that at lower levels it has a shorter range. And minor money for leveling to 15. That's honestly about it. There's really not a whole lot else going on in this patch. They gave the tank a new... The problem with the fireball skins, they had no head. They were basically designed around... Back when skins were all one solid piece, you had skins that did not take the head into consideration, like the fireball for assault and tank. And that made a problem because you had this head that didn't really change anything. So they added one for assault a few patches ago, and now they're adding one to tank. So that's a nice perk there. If you already have the head, then you'll get that updated one as well. So good on Uber for fixing things like that. But outside of that, that's about it for the patch. Like I said, Megabeth, she has her voice in. It's a sort of the Japanese with the gratuitous English thrown in. Kind of was expecting. I was hoping they'd be a little more original than that, but it sounds pretty okay. I really haven't heard it a whole lot, personally. I've only played like a practice match with her. I'm sensing a bug here, though, where you're hearing the voice acting being spoken by other characters. I was playing Combat Girl and I heard the assassin making Combat Girl voice responses, despite not actually being a, you know, Combat Girl. Which I don't think it's actually her speaking as Combat Girl. I think is that when you are playing as a character, it kind of changes your other characters' voice responses. You can hear in this video too. You'll hear I think the support making Wascot voice responses when he really shouldn't be. So that's a weird bug, but that's not super major. I'll have to play as the assassin and the support to see if it's them specifically, or if it's just a... I think it's not that. I think it's just that if you choose a character, they're going to sound like it's going to sort of spread to other characters. It's a weird bug. But yeah, that's about it for the patch. It's not, like I said, it's a very small patch. They are definitely ramping up here for PAX. And relating to PAX, I was, as I guessed yesterday, actually a few hours after I released my video yesterday, they confirmed that the new Defender will be revealed at PAX. I don't think they said anything about actually playing him, but that might be the case. But as far as that goes, that'll be really exciting. I will be at PAX, Uber's booth, probably one of the first booths I go to. So if you're heading to PAX and you see me there, I will... won't be there the entire time, but I will be there. I doubt I'll be playing. They're gonna have tournaments. They'll have some exclusive skins. They'll probably be re-releasing the... Last year they released a Cardboard Tube Samurai skin for PAX goers. I was at PAX last year, but I did not get it. I was not a big Monday Night Combat player, so I decided to pass on it. I think you had to buy something to get it, actually. I'm not quite sure about that, but I missed out on that. But I don't see why they wouldn't reuse the game assets for an extra skin like that. And hopefully we'll get something new besides just the Cardboard Tube Samurai skin. And they have tournaments going on. I'm not sure that's going to work out, but they will have... I'm not sure if you signed that beforehand or what, but they will have tournaments. And just, you know, give to developers and all that, so I will be there for that, and I'm looking forward to it. And besides that, we got a gameplay here right now. This is a decent game. It's a little mix. One player was new to Assassin, so he was not doing as well as he could have. But they did make, at some point here, they do make a decent attempt at a comeback. And they actually sort of scare me a little bit, because they do manage to push us back quite a bit. And get a few of our turrets down, so... Not a complete rollover. The game's about 20 minutes long. Especially compared to my last game. My last game was a roll. They, two levers in the first, like, 5 minutes of the game. I just couldn't believe it. People just do not want to give any sort of time to this game. Lose first Annihilator and you get at least one lever. Hopefully they'll get the matchmaking fully ramped up here so we can penalize people for that. But as getting back to Wascot here, I haven't played him in quite a bit. I've been kind of on a spark fix for a while, but playing him again, I kind of remember why I like him so much. One thing I didn't mention is actually they increased the size of his paddle back when they introduced the first weapon skins. I guess they increased the size, but it's actually, you know, you can see the actual skin itself. And made me pretty happy. I don't know, I like the giant overly sized paddle there. It'd be pretty cool to introduce more paddles where you can actually make it even larger to the two comic proportions. But this gameplay here, I was actually doing pretty well. I'm rolling with, once again, Generous Kill and Inspire because I am lazy and don't change my products like I should be. And using Fire Rate endorsements, just basic level 1 set. Was considering trying out some skill recovery endorsements with him, but with the nerf, I'm not going to bother right now. I'm going to wait. It's still going to be in flux like that. I'm rocking the Valentine's Day hat, but not the rest of the costume because I prefer... Well, I got the body, or I think I got the legs. I skipped the body because I don't like that hook on him, so... There you go with that. That's my reasoning for the costume, if you really care. But as far as the voice, I'm a little mixed. I've been playing Wascot so much and for so long with that original voice. It's a total 180 on his personality here. Part of it has grown on me as I played this game. This is my first game with the voice, so... Over the course of the game, I kind of grew on me. His sort of understated people compared him to Eeyore, which is kind of appropriate. And he'll say, funny lines like, I think, "Behold my radiant, my glory, my glorious radiance," in a very deadpan, monotone sort of voice. It definitely takes a lot of getting used to after that really energetic bullseye voice he was using before. But I think it's, I don't think it'll be too bad. It's kind of a stereotypical nerd voice, kind of making fun of really creepy nerds on the internet. And, obsessive fans and all that. And it's pretty, it's a pretty interesting twist on it. It's not entirely the stereotypical nerd. It's sort of, you got this hint of mental illness deep within there. And there I just died. So getting back to the game here, this is where they start to turn the game around. We're a little outnumbered at the Annihilator. I sort of overextend too much. I was going for a very low defense build here, so probably shouldn't have poked my head out like that. And that sort of gets me killed. I don't die too much here, so I'm not cutting out my deaths like I usually do. And I decided, since we lost Annihilator, go ahead and spawn those bots. Kind of would time me a little better and get a nice double Fuji wave, but do what you can. Yeah, for this build I was focusing on, I've kind of been happy lately with 2 points and Crook Hook. I'm looking at some guides, I know a lot of players are as well. It's a decent cooldown for that time. Once you get a lot of jump pads activated, you don't really need it to get around a whole lot unless you're trying to get the jump on somebody. You're mostly using it to stun people and escape when needed. Right here, we were at a bad spot. They were pushing us really hard on the right lane. I'm trying to sort of break that up, but at this point, I only get out of there probably because the combat girl was running away from those scramblers. So once again, I go back in from behind, get a little healed up here. Once again, I say I know I can kill her before those bots can kill me, so no problem, take them out real easy. And that sort of breaks up their little push back here, but they did get two. They did push in like 3 turrets at that point, so a very good turnaround for them. But at this point, we're back in control, pushing real hard here. Looking at trying to. I like to make sure I use up those ejectors when we got bots coming through so we can maintain that push. Right here, gonna save my assassin. Gonna go ahead, grab that assassin right as he juices. Take down the scramble. Always take down scramblers, ASAP as soon as you see them. They die real fast. They don't remain really scary very long, so take that real fast. Once again, I know I can get through here. I got plenty of regen on life, so I can easily take down those two classes and finish off the turret, which Carl wasn't paying attention to. Not that he can really do a whole lot, he's kind of alone there. Then go back to the next lane. You just gotta kind of be aware of what your lanes are doing. Top lane is always the left lane, and I was sort of getting a little worried there about the other lane, so I kind of pushed those bots. Sometimes you'll get to bots early and you have this weird mixed lane going on, but in most cases it should be fine. And right here, try and get out of here using that jump pad, and I know that if I roll off the edge there, I'll get a lot of a nice speed boost and easily outrun that combat girl. And right here, just clean up the lane. Trying to find a way to poke in. This is kind of the hard part of being a Wascot. I decided to go ahead and neutralize. Go ahead and neutralize that. What's her name? Megabeth. Usually Megabeth's rocket with the party pooper, but she goes into Rolling Dervish, so I guess it's kind of a waste. But at that point, gets stunned, gotta run out. And right, we're catching back up here. Trying to get in from behind, but it's really hard with the double defender. They got turrets everywhere, so I'm trying to find an area to just poke at. When I cannot find an opportunity to strike, I just go ahead and push the lane a little bit on the other side. Because as long as we're pushed up, we're fine, for the most part. All I do is just poke in, use Party Pooper to sort of decrease your power against the incoming bot wave. But at this point, I get killed because they find an opportunity to kill me, and I get pretty much just get triple grappled. Real frustrating, and I go down. So, at this point, we're really pushed up. We got level advantage on them. And only real problem here is making sure we watch that left lane. And make sure that we're not getting too backdoored or anything here. And right now, their left lane's okay. It's holding. Oh, same one show here. There, right there is a. Hit press M. You can see all the products people are using. I didn't take advantage of it too much in this game, but. 30 seconds to annihilator. If you are playing, it's probably wise to do that. Look at your opponent's. Look at your opponent's products. Look at your friend's products, because they might have something like a. Generous kill or something like that, which may be useful to know about. I notice here that they're trying to backdoor, which is kind of smart because our focus will be on the Annihilator. I decided to go, I don't say anything about it because I want to just be 1v2. That way we'll have an advantage at the Annihilator, while with the turret, I can pretty much reliably keep them away from the turret. Fortunate with that bouncer, but the plan works out of hitch. I mean, they are stuck over there. I easily kill him. I get an assist, which does not trigger off my thing. He had a actual... Important to looking at the products, he actually had the burn wave, it looked like. So, I'm not sure. That might have been hot hands. I think it was. I saw a bomb. I think that might have been the burn bomb when the person dies. So, try to make use of that product screen now, because that's going to be very useful for seeing what both your opponents are capable of, and in pugs, seeing what your team is capable of. But yeah, with that, we get the Annihilator and are able to push back up again. I guess they did push back a second time, but it was not nearly as effective as the last push. Right there, able to easily predict the Combat Girl's laser. A lot of them are pretty predictable with it. Sorry about that, I'm sneezing off camera there. Or off camera, yeah, because off microphone. Anyway, right here I'm trying to poke back in, but I'm trying to find a safe area. I killed their one combat kitty. I can easily go in here and just harass. Maybe not kill him, but I can easily harass the support there. Force him back. Sort of distract him from doing what he's supposed to do. Once again, there's no turret, so I can just head back in. He's trying to summon a bot, or I thought he was trying to summon a bot, so I go ahead and I interrupt that. And at this point, he easily dies. And I guess he wasn't buying a bot. I guess he was trying to leave the game. So there's our lever, but at this point the game is... I hate to say the game is over. It's likely we're going to win, but I don't think it's over. I think it's kind of a unfair thing to say. But yeah, here, that's a risky adrenal. If that jackpot had seen me, he might have killed me while I was getting there, but yeah. There is the weirdest chicky bounce knockback I've ever seen. Yeah, watch out for that. He can knock you off the edge if you're not careful. Here, once again, coming in from unpredictable angles. I'll survive the cat bot. And here we pretty much just grab Chicky. You can jump over Shockwave as you saw there. I think there's a minimum range for that. If he's if you're too close, you get knocked back no matter what. But I was not, so no problem. I get a dodge there. Carl plus a bouncer. Oh, that's gonna be real nasty. Gonna go ahead and just take care of this Fuji while waiting for better position for that. Megabeth has that Carl trap, so I'm gonna go ahead and stun him right there. I was trying to get him out of the grapple, but that failed. And yeah, he's pretty much dead. Good use of juice, good kill. And just finish off these bots right here. Another bouncer. And they're using both of our spawns at this point, so. So yeah, they're making a couple good pushes here, but they never quite seem to get that the kind of momentum they had last time, where they're really aggressively pushing the bots. They're trying to get Chicky. I thought we had Chicky pretty secure at this point, but the reason why we're not really pushing far ahead is because we're trying to waste our time at Chicky. And like I said before, putting three people... I left Chicky because I saw like three of us on it, and we did not need three people on Chicky, especially in a 4v5. We need like one at the... maybe two at the most, but really... I think with a 4v5, you can afford just one guy there to handle it. Chicky does not really attack you at all. He can if you're careless, but all you gotta really watch out about is the knockback. That's it. Two grapples, he's dead. That's why we weren't really pushing as hard as we could. Here, I'm being mindful of that Carl. If he wants to, he could grapple me. And I also managed to get a line just in time for the Megabeth. Grab her. Crook the I was hoping that Carl make sure he would not get that grapple off, because I didn't want him knocking away my my teammate. Not sure if he was lined up properly for the ring out, but you never know. And they may assume you're grappling me. I counterattack, and now I'm at the turret here. Secondary turret saw me, so we're going to go ahead and just start finishing this game up here. I'm always looking at the top of the screen. As you see right there, the other bot wave is heading towards us. I'm kind of trying to... I'm aware the other bot wave is progressing towards our turrets, but I kind of want to finish this at this point because it's a 4v5. It's not really fun when you're on a 4v5 and losing, so I'm hoping we get down that turret and then head back. So I'm going to go ahead and just... I was expecting a laser there, so I was going to dodge, but... See, now our turret's being attacked, and I'm heading back at this point because I was hoping that it wouldn't be this case, but... You got to race back now. At this point, I see that we're not being attacked anymore. When your little shield icon's looking red, it means your rocket towers are being attacked. We got Annihilator. Again, we don't really need Annihilator, but, you know... Whatever makes the game go faster. I'm right here just going to clean up things for Annihilator. Always go for the Comet Girl first. She's going to try to lose me on the bouncer, but she fails to. Don't stop for Regenerals if you're that close to death. Nothing's going to happen. You're going to get attacked. It's going to shut off your generation. You're going to die anyway. And you just waste 250 for your cash. And of course she died. So yeah, turret's now down. Annihilator puts our lanes back in a more favored position. I'm going to go ahead and just harass him from the side. I don't want to risk getting hit by that turret, because I'm still a little... I guess not that squishy anymore. Surprisingly, that Megabeth got rammed by that bouncer. I was not aware of that until I found it the hard way, but they can ram you off the side if you're not careful. They have a charge. And he's going to juice and go ahead and finish this off, and that will be the game. So I hope you all enjoyed watching that. I will try to have some more videos out this weekend. Hopefully, we shall see. And I hope to see you all at PAX as well if you are coming. PAX East is April, I think, the weekend of April 6th, so I will see you then. Hope you enjoyed the video. Give the patch a try, listen to the new voices and all that. And yeah, don't go assassin first time, I guess. That's it. See y'all later.